Our God is wonderful. Our God is marvelous. Our God is powerful. He's the Ancient of Days, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the I am that I am. He's a mighty God. Your God is a mighty God. He will fight your battle. The Bible said, let God arise and let all our enemy be scattered. In the name of Jesus, in this month of March, all that stand against you shall be scattered in the name of Jesus. Ye shall march forward. I say you shall march forward. You will march forward. You will march forward. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Stand on your feet.
Lord Jesus,
I thank you for today. Lord Jesus, I thank you for today. May your name be glorified. Have mercy upon me. Have mercy upon me. In your mighty name, Jesus Christ. Jesus, come into me. Dwell in me. Lead me. And teach me. Jesus, I love you. Let your love fill my heart. Father, I thank you. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Please be seated. Congratulations. Who are you? Yes. Ask yourself, who am I? If you don't know who you are, you can never have a true happiness in life. Life will become a struggle, a daily struggle. You will struggle until you are old without satisfaction and you leave this earth. And that is why you must know who you are. Who are you? Who are you? Who you are does not identify you with what you have. You cannot say you know yourself because of the wealth you have. Because you are rich, you have cars, you have money, and you have houses. Those material things, worldly things, cannot give you a true satisfaction in life. A true satisfaction and the peace of life comes from knowing yourself, who you are. When you know who you are in life, you'll be satisfied. You'll be able to enjoy this earth. You'll be able to have a true relationship with man. But the question you ask yourself today, how do I know who I am? Who are you? To know who you are, you must be close to God. There must be a personal relationship with God. A relationship with God. True, sincere relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible said Moses was a man, an Hebrew son, an Hebrew child, who was taken care by the palace. He grew up in the palace. He ate, drank, and had all the good things of life. They had money, wealth, authority. They can do everything. Their clothes were made in gold. He was a child with all authority and wealth because he grew up in the palace. He was being taken care by the queen of the Egyptian as at that time. He grew up in the house of Pharaoh. But when he grew up, he had no true satisfaction because he does not know who he is. Who are you? Do you know who you are? Before you can enjoy your breakthrough and your blessings, you must know who you are. You are does not mean you are a lawyer or you are a doctor. You are an engineer. You had all these things. No. Those things do not give true satisfaction. They do not give true peace of heart. Money cannot give you who you are. Like some will say, do you know who I am? I am the counselor, I am the governor, I am the chairman. No, that is not you. It's just temporary. But the real you will be asking you the question, who are you? Because there's no satisfaction. But when you come close to God, God will tell you who you really are. A personal relationship with God. A personal relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible said, Moses was not satisfied with the kind of life he was living. And he ran out of his wealth, out of his power, out of his authority, out of the palace. And he went into the desert. In Exodus chapter 3, the Bible said Moses became a shepherd. Exodus chapter 3, he became a shepherd. He took the sheep of his father-in-law, Jethro, to the back of the desert to feed them. And as he was feeding them, in verse 2, the Bible said, he saw an angel. An angel of the Lord appeared to Moses. Remember, Moses took the sheep of his father-in-law. He was already a man, but he does not know God. He had no relationship with God. He has not known God. He was a man, married, but he has not known God. He has no relationship with God. And the Bible said, when he saw the angel, he saw the bush burning. Fire was on the bush, but the bush was not burning. And the Bible said he went closer to the bush. He wanted to see. And the angel called him. God called him in the burning bush and said, Moses. And he wondered, who is this person that is calling me? But he had no choice because that is the voice that communes with your own spirit. The day you hear the voice of God, even if you do not know God, you will answer, here I am, because he's your creator. Your spirit knows him. But your soul may not recognize him as at that time. But that spirit will answer, yeah, I am. And the Bible said, God spoke to Moses and said, in verse 6, I am the God of your father. That is to tell you, Moses has not known God at all, at all. Yet, he was an Hebrew son. But he does not know God. The God of Abraham, the God of your father Isaac, the God of your father Jacob, I am the one that is calling you. Pull off your shoes. Where you are standing is an holy ground. He was so powerful. He was the only one that can meet with God and bring message to the Israelites. Greater than any wealth. That is it. If you have a divine encounter with God,
You will know who you are, and you will know your authority and your power that is greater than the wealth of this earth. Who are you? Moses had internal, and he did the work of God. And God bless him. God will bless you today. In Acts of Apostles chapter 9, the Bible said Paul was a persecutor. In verse 3, Jesus called him, Paul, Saul, Saul, why art thou persecuting me? He was afraid. Who is this Jesus Christ? Saul had no relationship with Jesus Christ. He had his own faith as an Hebrew man who believed in the Jewish religion. He only knew Jehovah God. He needed no Jesus Christ. But he doesn't know that you cannot separate Christ from God, from Jehovah God. But the day he met with Jesus, he discovered who he was supposed to be, who he was. And from that day, the Bible said, he became a bridge builder between the Gentiles and Jesus Christ. A bridge builder. Paul was a bridge builder between Jesus Christ and the Gentiles. The Gentiles are you. We are one of the Gentiles who, by the grace of his blood on the cross of Calvary, was converted or adopted into the Christian, into the kingdom of Jehovah God. By the sharing of his blood, we are adopted children. It was Paul that brought this message to you. Paul brought the message to you. That was himself. Who are you? And from that day, he discovered himself. He had internal satisfaction because he was not satisfied before. He was going about persecuting the Christian. But the day he met with Jesus Christ, the Bible said he had internal peace and he became a bridge builder. Today, the peace of God will come upon your life. You are going to meet God one-on-one today. You are going to have an internal encounter with the Lord Jesus Christ today. May God bless you as you hear the word of God. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The Bible says in the book of Psalm 122, it said, when the captivity of Zion, when the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, we were like them that dream. Our mouths were filled with laughter. Our tongue were singing songs. And there was the news among the unbelievers that God has done a new thing in their life. Yes, God is going to do a new thing in your life today. Because God is going to turn around your captivity. God is going to turn around your bondage today. God is going to turn your imprisonment today. Somebody shout hallelujah.